Hello everyone, my name is Tiffany and I am a realtor here in Sacramento, California. I'm just showing a listing of one of the agents in my office and I just wanted to show you around the house and a tour of what some of the houses here in Sacramento look like. So here we go.
See, it's the same thing, no rules, same rhythm, no blues, same love, but this time it really ain't love, no reason, no rhyme.
All right, so this is the entrance of the home. Excuse my car, shouldn't have parked it there, but yeah, so I really like the walkway to get to the door just because it's has a lot of plants and it looks very, I guess, tropical in a way. Obviously not every home is going to have that. It always depends on the owner and how they upkeep their home or their property, so it really just depends on the owner and how they take care of it basically. Okay, anyways, I didn't document getting into the house just because it was a little bit tricky and I have to use my phone to do that, and I'm recording on my phone. But basically this is the living area that you saw the fireplace there and everything, and it leads to the kitchen. So I'm gonna walk you through the kitchen. Obviously there's a sink. It's a pretty nice kitchen. It's not that very big. It doesn't have like the island appeal that most people like, but I believe it's really nice. I really like the countertops. It has a big fridge. I'm showing you the inside here. It does come with the listing, so that's also a good thing, is when the appliances come with the listing, because it just makes it so much easier because you don't have to move your stuff around and bring your old fridge or appliances to your new house. So yeah, that's the fridge there, and here's more of the kitchen and everything, and you got an oven, stove, all of that. That's the backyard. We're gonna take you back there later, so I'm gonna show you more of the rooms right now. So I'm walking down the hall, and right here near the entrance there is a place to just store your shoes and maybe your purse or coats or even towels and stuff for all of the rooms, which is nice. Has a good amount of space there. And yeah, that's me right there. Hello. That's my outfit right there. So anyways, we're gonna go towards the first bedroom here. This first bedroom is really nice. I think it's a good size too, because it is 13 by 10 feet. So I really like it. And we also have some nice windows here, and it looks out into the front yard and it's a nice view. Then this is the closet over here. That's me again. Hi. I think it's a good size. I don't have much clothes, so for me it would be nice. I don't know about other people, but it's a normal sized closet. So I'm gonna take you down here and we're gonna go to the next room. It is a bit smaller than the other one. This one is 10 by 9 feet. So if you have kids and, you know, they're fighting over a room, one of them is gonna be upset. But this is the closet here. It's pretty much the same like the other one. Now we're gonna go down towards the master bedroom and the bathroom. This is the first bathroom here. That's me again, hi. One sink, toilet obviously, nice tub. Little small bathroom, it's cute. Now this is the master bedroom here. So it is 13 by 13 feet. We have a nice little window there again. So this is the closet for the master bedroom. It's much bigger than the other ones. There's some storage on the top where you could put your stuff, and for sure a lot bigger than the other ones. But this is where the bathroom is. So I gotta say, this is a bit weird. I don't like how there's carpet where you have to wash your face and wash your hands and everything, but that's just me personally. I would put the tile from over there and put it right there, Just section it off a little bit because it's a little weird, but this is the bathroom here. I really like this shower. I like when showers have glass coverings instead of like the tub look. The reason why that is just because I feel like it's easier to clean and it looks more clean instead of a tub. But now we're back here in the living room. I'm gonna take everyone back to the backyard. And let me tell you, this backyard, I love it. It's so beautiful. There's a pond there and it's a good size grass area. I really like how it's like a porch where it's covered so you have shade and you could just sit there and if you want, drink a cup of coffee in the morning or whatever you do, read a book. Just look at that. It's so pretty. So yeah, I really like this backyard just because it's so serene and it just has like a jungle feel to it. So it's really nice. But yeah, so this is the side of the house. There's a little area you could plant and trees. If you want, you could park something back here, like your car. But yeah, it's pretty simple stuff. But the rest of the backyard is just really beautiful in my opinion. And there's a shed here that you could put tools in and whatnot. I'm not gonna go in there and show you because that's a little creepy. So, and we got a lime tree. Who else loves limes here? Comment down below. But yeah, we're going back into the house. I'm gonna show the garage. It's probably a two-car garage. I'm not completely sure, just because there's some cabinets over there that might cut into the space, but I think two cars may fit in there, but they have to be small cars, obviously. So yeah. All right, everyone. So that was the end of the tour for this house. Like I said, it's a beautiful home. These are some of what Sacramento houses look like, but I think they're beautiful, they're nice, and they're cozy, homey. Like I said, the backyard, beautiful, really good selling point, as well as the kitchen. If you really like this video, you could give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I am a new realtor. I'm trying to get my clientele up, but I am doing it. All right, so this part's just super duper awkward, and I'm just gonna do a voiceover of what I was trying to say. But have a wonderful day, everyone. Thank you for watching. Just remember, success is a process. Don't try to rush it. Be kind, be respectful, stay humble.
Doesn't it feel like this could be real life if we had something to prove?